Hello friends, welcome to this video on polynomials. Today, we will learn about the factor theorem and splitting the middle term related to polynomials. In the previous video, we learned about the remainder theorem, which states that when a polynomial P of x with power 1 or more than 1 is divided by a linear polynomial x minus a, gives a remainder P of A. And taking this theorem one step further, the factor theorem states that if P of A gives the remainder 0, that is, if x minus A divides P of x completely, then x minus A is a factor of P of x. And if x minus A is a factor of P of x, then P of A will be 0. Let's see an example related to this theorem. Check whether x plus 3 is a factor of the polynomial 2x squared plus 7x plus 3 or not. According to the factor theorem, if x plus 3 is a factor of the polynomial 2x squared plus 7x plus 3, then P of minus 3 should be 0, where minus 3 is obtained by equating x plus 3 to 0. That is, if we write the polynomial this way, we have to check whether P of minus 3 is 0 or not. So let's check it. Now we can say that, according to the factor theorem, x plus 3 is a factor of this polynomial. Friends, can there be more factors of this polynomial? Yes. The number of factors of a polynomial depends on the highest power of the variable of the polynomial. For example, a quadratic polynomial has two linear factors and a cubic polynomial has three factors, etc. So now, let's learn how to find all the factors of a polynomial. For this, we have two methods. One is factor theorem and the second is splitting the middle term. Suppose we are given a quadratic polynomial 2x squared plus 7x plus 3. From this, we will derive the factors using the factorization method and splitting the middle term method. First, let's see the factorization method. The polynomial is 2x squared plus 7x plus 3. To solve using this method, the coefficient of x squared has to be 1. So we can take 2 common out of it and write it like this. 2 of x squared plus 7 by 2x plus 3 by 2. Now, if we write x squared plus 7 by 2x plus 3 by 2 equal to P of x, then this will become 2P of x. And suppose, if a and b are its two zeros, then you can write this polynomial in terms of factors as 2P of x is equal to 2 of x minus a of x minus b. And here, you can see that the constant is AB. That is, for this polynomial, AB is 3 by 2. So we will find two numbers A and B, whose product is 3 by 2. First of all, plus or minus 1 and the number itself, that is plus or minus 3 by 2 are the factors. Also, 3 by 2 can be written as 3 multiplied by 1 by 2, that is, plus or minus 3 and plus or minus 1 by 2 will also be factors. Thus, some possible values of A and B can be plus or minus 1, plus or minus 1 by 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 3 by 2. Now, substituting all these values in the polynomial, we have to find which of these will make the value of the polynomial 0. P of minus 1 by 2 will be 0 and P of minus 3 will be 0. We get the values of A and B. Now, we can write them in terms of factors of polynomials as x plus 1 by 2 and x plus 3. And finally, we get only two factors of this polynomial as it is a quadratic polynomial. Now, let's solve this polynomial using the method of splitting the middle term and see if their results are the same or not. Friends, we have learned this method in the context of quadratic equations in our previous session. As you all know, here we will multiply the coefficient of x square, that is 2, and the constant 3 to get 6. And then, find two such numbers whose product is 6 and sum is the coefficient of the middle term, that is 7. The numbers whose product is 6 and sum is 7 are 6 and 1. Now, we will split the middle term and write it like this. So here we can see that, in both the situations, we get the same factors. You can check whether the polynomials is being reduced to 0 by finding the value of x from both the factors. Friends, that's all in this video. So what did we learn in today's video? Factor theorem and splitting the middle term. Now let's meet in the next video where we will solve some questions based on this topic. Thank you.